Good morning, everyone. It is time. It is time to silence your lovely devices and even your voices for just a moment. I am filling in for Chris Whiteneck today. And we're going to have some fun. I mean, we always have fun with Chris, too, but... Yeah, so devices off, and we're going to do a little bit of a thank you song. Yeah, you can stand. We're going to start with four thank yous. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This wonderful, day. This wonderful, day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This beautiful day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This healing day. This healing day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This joyful day. This joyful day. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, thank you for this amazing day. Isn't this not an amazing day? Woo! And it's really amazing because all of you are here. Look at your beautiful faces. Woo! Whoa, wonderful. Are you ready to open your heart and your consciousness and anchor in an experience of spirit? Yeah, okay, that's why we're here. I'm Reverend Victoria Loveland-Coen, and to my left is the wonderful Oswaldo Mora. And you are at Unity Center of Peace.
Thank you.
Chapel Hill. And there's somebody taking photos here. I have to just introduce. This is my daughter, Juliet.
Hi, Juliet.
She's taking some photos to update our website and all of that stuff. So thank you for being patient with that. And we want to say hello to those of you joining us online on YouTube and Facebook. Thank you for being here. If you would just say hi in the chat, then we know that you're here. We get a conversation going. All right, so without further ado, let's have Oswaldo light the divine light candle and just really allow ourselves to be present to that element of fire. And I invite you to say our opening invocation, which is on that buff sheet in the seat back in front of you, if you're not yet familiar. But first, really connect in with your heart center. Take a breath. And together, there is only one presence and one power active in the universe and in my life. God, the good omnipotence. Breathe that in, feel the reality of that, that possibility of infinite good right here in this moment, available to us right now. And so it is.
So it is.
Thank you.
surrender. I trust and I know. As I surrender, I fall into the arms of love. I surrender. I trust and I know. As I surrender, I fall into the arms of love. I fall into the arms of love.
Good morning. Before we go in meditation, I just want to share little thing that happened this week. You know, I'm very familiar with numbers, and I was seeing so many times the number 59. And 59, I always feel it's like a challenge coming. A challenge is coming. So then I went to do a deposit in the bank, and the final amount was with 59 cents. And I said, okay. But then the cashier was checking the number, said, I'm missing 2 cents. So in this deposit, something was wrong, and instead of 59, it's supposed to be a 57. And 57 is the number of being grateful, the gratitude. So I said, wow, what a message. I'm going to change that perception of challenge for the perception of gratitude. So today I want to and guide you in the journey of changing that perception. Life cannot be a challenge if I choose to be grateful for the life that I have. So I invite you to close your eyes. And of course, you're pretty familiar with the word challenge. If I surrender to the presence, there is no need to challenge. Just being grateful is enough. With your eyes closed, you will be able to experience that deep presence in you. That presence that we call life is divine. Inhale, exhale. Knowing that you are transforming your patterns of challenging to gratitude. Breathe and feel divine consciousness. It's in you. You are supported by this divine consciousness, the divine. Recognize that. Get rid of the idea of challenges and connect with your gratitude state. Breathe and go deep. Deep and go deep. Sustaining yourself. Knowing in your heart that you are in the state of gratitude. Breathe. I'm grateful. So I invite you to share that gratitude state with the ones that you love, the ones that are in your life, the ones that you care. By saying their names, you share your gratitude and release the idea of challenge. I'm grateful for your presence. And say the name. I'm grateful for your presence. And say the name. Breathe. In that state of gratitude, our dear Joy is going to pray over the box.
Divine love is enfolding the dear ones with requests in this box and requests in the hearts of those, maybe the request, it didn't make quite into the box. We are affirming spirits gently guiding and guarding toward a realization of their wholeness in mind, spirit, and body. Love is having its perfect work, and so it is.
So it is. Take a deep breath. And I invite you to come back, little by little, being present. Well, that was good.
I'm grateful for that.
To tell you the truth, that changed my week, changing the idea of challenge to the idea of gratitude. It was great. So now we're going to focus on our vision and mission. We have a very beautiful service today, so we must keep connected. Walk with me. Our vision. We envision the divine light awakening in all. Our mission. We center in peace and love. We connect in our hearts with others. We celebrate our journey toward wholeness, and we empower others to experience their spiritual magnificence. And so it is. Got it.
Welcome, Glenn Jones.
Thank you.
You're so in happy for a treat.
So happy to be back. Thank you for having me. A song by Ricky Byers Beckwith, I'll bet you know. Hope you'll sing on the chorus.
I am all that I have and I am all that I'm
Oh, yeah. That's what I'm talking about right there. There is some music. That was Ricky Byers, right? Yeah. In the Land of I Am. You guys did such a beautiful job. Woo! Thank you. What a way to start a morning. Yes. Good morning. Good morning. Yes. Okay. So we are continuing our journey today in the metaphorical aspect, the metaphorical themes that we have discovered in the Easter story. Knowing that all of the Gospels, all of the Gospel accounts are very different from one another, but there are some themes in common. And if we look at the metaphorical aspect of those themes, it can really enhance our spiritual journey. So we talked last week, remember, we focused on the whole idea of the feminine aspect of Mary, the Marys, and how, you know, the angels and Jesus himself appeared to the women. And the men didn't get it, right? They just didn't see it. Even when it was right in front of them, they didn't see it. And we talked about, no, it's not really the gender. It's the feminine and masculine aspect of us and how to develop that, right? And so today, our focus is the empty tomb. Everybody kept looking in the empty tomb, right? Where the body of Jesus lay very briefly, but it's no longer there. And they just keep looking in the tomb, looking into a place that is no longer relevant. So Mary goes in there. She said the angel appears, tells her what's happening. She understands. She goes to tell the disciples. They don't get it. In John's version, all of the disciples go into the tomb to see for themselves, right? And they go in there, and they're looking around, and they can't understand. They can't see another possibility other than somebody has taken the body of their Lord, right? They have completely forgotten the whole prophecy about the resurrection. They can't see it. Because they're looking in the wrong place. They're looking in a place that holds no more life. It's not relevant, right? Or they're seeing with their eyes, you know, metaphorically closed. Now, their eyes, you know, eventually opened, and the rest is history or legend, depending upon how you see it. All points of view are valid here. And so the metaphor here is pretty easy. In fact, it's so simple that I think we're tempted to just kind of dismiss it, right? But I really want us to take us a little deeper. So where are we focusing our attention and our energy in a place that no longer is alive, that no longer has vibrancy? Or that is no longer valuable, that holds no value? Or where are we so focused on the problem that we can't see anything else? Or where are we stuck in an old idea? Maybe old thinking like, oh, well, it's just the way it is. It'll never change. Where are we stuck in that? You know, knowing that actually when we look at the current state of things, this temporary, ever-changing world of form and experience, we're actually not seeing what truly is. We are seeing the result of yesterday's thinking, the result of yesterday's false ideas, yesterday's actions. But today is new. In this moment, we have a new opportunity to awaken to a new possibility. But we can't see it if we keep looking at the problem. If we keep looking at for what's missing, right? Or if we keep looking to someone or something outside of us, you know, for the answer. Or to bring us happiness, you know? I know, it's very much human nature to look at the temporary world of form and experience because, you know, it's just so seductive. You know, our eye goes to the next shiny thing. Yeah, it's good. Yeah, I want that. I want more of that. right? Forgetting, we forget that it all comes from in here, that the power comes from in here. Or maybe we are looking to something else or something in the world to change in order for us to be happy. So if you find yourself thinking, oh, when this happens, or when I get this, then I'll be happy. That's a clue, right? When it really is, the power is within us to A, see it differently, B, make the change, and C, really be the change. It's all within us. So, the thing is, when our attention is so focused on the problem, or what's missing, or what's wrong, or something outside of us to fix it for us, or, you know, to be the answer for us, we are not really seeing. And the question then becomes, what are we missing? What are we missing? What are we not seeing? What powerful and expansive vision within us is not being revealed? Because we're not giving it any focus. Or what authentic gift that is ours to give is not being given. So, Sheena Mead was a single teen mom who was rebuilding her life after an abusive relationship. And she's getting her life together. She now has 4 kids. She's a single mom. She's raising them by herself. And she's really beginning to put her life together. And it is a typical Saturday morning. Her kids are running around, they're screaming, they're having fun, they're watching Saturday morning cartoons, and everything is good until she hears a knock on the door. She goes to answer the door. There are 2 policemen that are there to arrest her. They're arresting her for writing a check for $87.26 to the grocery store to feed her family because she was waiting for a check to come in that she thought would cover it before the other one cleared, which it didn't. And so they handcuffed her in front of her kids and took her off in a squad car. Now, because this was her first offense, she was released pretty quickly, but she now had a record, and that record stayed with her. And she made it difficult for her to get a job, to rent an apartment, to obtain a certificate, a license, any kind of license, to apply for college, which was her plan, to even volunteer at her kids' school. And she shares from the TED stage that this is true for millions of other people who have had one arrest, who have made one mistake. And she shares in this TED Talk that she knows that there are laws. There are laws on the book that help people clear their record. But she says, you gotta have money. You need money to pay the fees and to hire a lawyer who can help you navigate the red tape of this whole experience. And she says, if your crime is being poor, which is what hers was, you know, that record clearance is just not an option. And so this experience could have sent this single mom spiraling downward. But she didn't see herself as a victim. She refused to look at the situation in her life and feel victimized by it. She refused to look into that empty tomb, into the darkness, into what wasn't, what was missing, and what had no hope. And instead, she looked to herself. She went within, and she found her strength. She found her power. And she said, I'm going to be the answer here. I'm going to change this for myself and for millions of others. And so fast forward a few years, she has actually founded a foundation that helps millions of people now with automatic record clearance. She ended up going to school. She became the CEO of the Clean Slate Initiative. And so she and the people who work with her go from state to state to advocate and to help change the laws. And she's incredibly successful in doing this. She was even behind the, remember a few years ago that Florida passed a new law where they restored the voting rights for people who were previously incarcerated? And you're going, oh, Florida, really? She was behind that. She was one of the people behind that. She turned her pain into her purpose. She turned her pain into her purpose. This is the power of looking within, looking to the right place, which is within us, to that highest divine self that is within us, to be the presence, to guide us, to move us into action. That's the power, right? That's the power in the present. Now, is Sheena an extraordinary woman? Yes and no, right? She had the ability, the willingness to look within herself and find her inner warrior, right? Her goddess warrior woman. And she stood in that truth. And she made it happen. She made it happen. Whereas millions of other people, you know, just keep looking to the empty tomb of a dysfunctional world and feel trapped in it. But she doesn't have any power that we don't have, right? And I'm willing to bet many of you have at one point in your lives, think back, there was a circumstance maybe where you were tempted to think, I don't know, I don't think I can do anything here. But instead, you looked within and you found your power and you found your strength and you found your ability to stand in your truth and say, I'm not going to let this stop me. Right? I'm not going to let this stop me, or I'm not going to waste another moment of this precious life focusing on something that has no value. I'm going to do whatever I need to do to grow and realize more of my full potential. Right? And when I do that, how many others can I also help? Yeah, I'll bet you have. You know? And so do you want to have that experience be a little more common? So that we know that we can rely on it, that every time there is a circumstance or a temptation to say, I can't do this, this is not going to change, or, you know, temptation to kind of waste time on something not valuable. More often, do we want more often to know the truth, to look at the right place, to that place within us, right? That highest divine self within us, that it can be the change through, in, and as us. Okay. Yes? Do you want that experience more often? I invite you to take out the handout that is in your program. And there are a set of questions. Hang on just a second. And we're going to spend a couple of minutes with this. We're going to spend a couple of minutes with this. And let me just read through the questions. And then, you know, if anything comes to you right now, go ahead and write it down. But I want you to be able to take this home, right? To spend some time and focus on it. And to go into the silence and really allow that divine guidance to come up. So the first question is, where have I been looking that's not holding any real value for me? If anybody doesn't have a program or a handout, please raise your hand. We have a couple down here. Yep, three, four. We got four, thank you. The people have snuck in without getting a program. There you go. All right, so that first question is, where have I been looking that's not holding any real value for me? Second is, what is seizing my attention that's not serving me? The third question is, how am I stuck in yesterday's limited thinking? How about, what am I looking to as the source of my happiness? Or where have I been overly focused on the problem? There should be a pen in the back, the seat back in front of you. If something occurs to you, go ahead and write it down. Let's take a moment with it. Do you have one? Do you have one? Let's take a moment and look at that. And then the next set of questions. What power do I have within myself to find the solution or to make a change? What is my true source? What possibility can I begin to realize? What possibility can I begin to realize? And how can I turn my pain into my purpose? This is what Sheena did. She turned her pain into her purpose. That's a big one. So again, if something occurs to you, bubbling up from the surface, from your inner wisdom, go ahead and write it down. Keep breathing. Would take about 30 seconds more and finish up. And again, take this home with you. Spend some time. Go into the silence. Dig a little deeper and really allow that wisdom to come up, because this can make a huge difference for you. Just becoming aware of it, right? That's always the first step, is to become aware of this. Make a huge shift. You know, looking to the source of our power, of our strength, of our very life, of our very being, which is that infinite divine presence through and as us, through and as all of us. And then we begin to walk that path, and we walk it together, and my God, how fun is that? To come together and walk in that energy together. Play in that energy together. So let's do an affirmation that really helps to anchor this into us, okay? So repeat after me. I've got everything I need within me. Everything I need within me to realize my divine potential. Realize my divine potential. Yes, and so it is. Namaste.
song I wrote about pie. And on its face, you wouldn't think that has much to do with refocusing, but it occurred to me, you know, when I'm having a bad day, when I'm stressed, when my head is a million miles away, my wife is a great, fantastic baker, and she should have stock in King Arthur, I swear. But today's her anniversary, but she's working at UNC Hospital, she'd be here. But anyway, she's in a, yeah, thank you, 5 years, and she's a saint. And she's an amazing baker. So if I'm having, whatever I'm doing, I come home late from a gig, exhausted or whatever, if there's a fresh pie there, like, there's nothing that you instantly smile and it's wonderful. Anyway, here's the song. It's called My Baby Makes Pie. Took my baby to the movies. Went okay, I guess, nothing too great. Then for the next time out, she put her moves on me. Gave me an invite to an afternoon tea. I opened the door, smelled it, left it to smell. Saw a beautiful sight that I remember well, yeah.
A very sweet song. And I want some pie. Mi amor, next stop is pie store. So, talking about pies, it's gonna be some pie after the service in the kitchen. So, I guess. At this very moment, I'm gonna invite you to bring from wherever you are yourself and give yourself in generous ways, because we want you here present in all the ways. And one of those ways is financially, you know. That way we support the community, we support the programs, we support all the beautiful things that we create here. Besides that, all the happiness that you bring, all the smiles, all the beautiful faces, I see a lot of money here. That's what I mean. So whatever way you choose to do your donation today, I invite you to hold in your hand. And it's not a challenge. Remember, today is not about being a challenge. This is just a reason to be grateful. So we are grateful for that capacity in our hearts of sharing what we are. As always say, when we share what we have, we may not have at the end. But when we share what we are, that multiplies. So let's share what we are. We hold that in our hearts. And from there, I invite you to sustain the blessing of the gifts. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, all that I receive, and all that I am. So it is.
The power of love is here now. The power of you and me is here to create magic on earth. The power of love is here now. The power of now is here now. The power of you and me is here to create magic on earth. The power of love is here now. The power of now is here now. The power of you and me is here to create magic on earth. The power of love is here now. The power of now is here now. The power of you and me is here to create magic on earth. The power of love is here now. The power of now is here now. Power of you and me is here to create magic on earth. The power of love is here now. The power of now is here now. The power of you and me is here to create magic on earth.
Magic on earth. You know, I just remember something that happened more than 25 years ago when I started coming to Unity. I shared that to my friend. We were living in New York. She said, Unity, but that is a church for rich people. And I said, really? Great. So let's bring that moment. And yes, we are rich. So from there, we bless our sharings today. We bless our hearts, because that's where we are. We are rich people in a rich life, sustained in spirit. And so it is.
So it is.
Amen.
All right. Yes, indeed. We've got the prayer box here that Pat is taking out to the foyer, and so if you'd like to have your prayer request prayed over during the service, oh, there's something over there, trying to get somebody getting your attention, please go ahead and write a request and put it in the box, and the prayer team will pray over it, absolutely, and we will do it here on Sunday as well. And we want to welcome anybody who might be visiting us for the first time today. If you are new, hopefully you, yes, yeah, hi. You had a packet of information, but if not, raise your hand and somebody will come by and put that packet of information. You did, okay, so there's a little blue card on the outside. If you'll fill out both of those sides and return to one of the greeters, we have a little gift for you in that All right. And if you are joining us for the first time today online, welcome. We're glad to have you here. Say, hey, it's my first time today. And our wonderful host, Mel, will give you as much information about Unity as you'd like. All right. Wonderful. Let's have one more song. Yeah, Glenn, come on up.
Another one. I know you know the chorus too. Please sing loud and enthusiastically.
And you wrote this one too,
right? No, I did not. Or I would be rich. Yeah. When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom. Let it be. Darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom. Let it be, oh, let it be, let it be, let it be, yeah, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be. And when the broken-hearted people
now. Seems like a good time. If you don't follow my words, all the announcements are listed in the program that you have been handed today earlier. And we're going to start with the first one here. We need to get an LED TV sanctuary fundraiser going. Unity Center of Peace is ready to go its next technological upgrade with a wall-mounted LED TV screen at the front of our sanctuary. This enhancement to our Sunday celebration will allow us to incorporate engaging announcement slides, congregant song lyrics, and even zoom in guest speakers. And most of all, save paper and ink and be more earth friendly. And I believe Miss Victoria Coen would like to say something.
Yes, I did.
Reverend.
I did, because so when I was sharing the story about Sheena Mead, she has a TED talk. If we had, just imagine for a moment, if you would, if we had a beautiful LED screen, I could show her picture so that you could see, and I would show a little bit of the TED talk when she's speaking. So just kind of get that, and it would just help you to get a sense of who this person is and what she's about. So just keep that in mind. Thanks.
And donate. Thank you to those individuals that have contributed thus far, helping to manifest this long-awaited dream. No contribution is too small or too great. Check the poster in the foyer for our progress thermometer and scan the QR code to contribute. More details are in your Sunday program. All right, two. Adult Game Night Mixer this Tuesday at 6 p.m. in our lovely sanctuary for our monthly Adult Game Night Mixer. Adults and teens are welcome. Bring a snack and prepare for an evening of laughter and fun with your UCP family. Adopt a Highway Cleanup. UCP has adopted Sewell School Road to clean up 4 times per year. That's the one out here in between the high school and us. Our spring roadside cleanup is scheduled for Saturday, April 20th. That would be next Saturday from 9:30 to 12:30. Volunteers are still needed. Please sign up on the sheet on the infamous back table or use the QR code in your Sunday program. Next Sunday, April 21st, right after the service, we will celebrate and welcome our new guest artist, Linda Gaines. Is that someone we know, Gaines? No? Okay. All right. If you're enjoying the new art display in our sanctuary, you won't want to miss this opportunity to meet Linda and find out what inspires her unique creativity. Light refreshments will be provided. Sorry about that. All right. You are the placebo. Joe Dispenza's study group. Joanne Maria Cavanaugh in a deep dive study of the work and teachings of Dr. Joe Dispenza. This is a 5-week study series beginning April 22nd on Mondays from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. in the sanctuary. That would be a week from Monday. Use the QR code in your Sunday program to sign up or use the sign-up sheet on the back table. All right. If you need prayer or support for any of your concerns, our prayer partner, Karen Roll, will be happy to pray with you after the service in room 102 with a 3-minute miracle.
It's Joy Bell.
It says Karen Roll. Okay. If you need prayer support for any prayer concern, Joy Bell will be happy to pray with you after the service in room 102. We call it a 3-minute miracle. Online viewers can email a prayer at unitychapelhill.org for a prayer request, and our prayer partner will call you back and pray with you over the phone. Please include your phone number in your email. All right. There are no more slides. So our outreach team is in meeting today right after the service. If you're interested in joining this team or attending the meeting, talk with Judith or Maria after the service. Did Judith or Maria want to say anything along
after
those lines?
Service.
Okay. After the service, they will say stuff about that. Our beautiful flower arrangement this week is by Kellyanne Skutvik in honor of her father and stepmother's 50th wedding anniversary on April 13th. All right. Some may know, if you don't know, Reverend Victoria is going on a sabbatical, and we have Ravana Quintana, I believe is how it is said, has an announcement about her upcoming month-long talk series, and welcome her to UCP.
Come on up, Ravana Quintana. Please come on up.
I like you already. So I'll be here from May 12th through June 2nd, mm-hmm. And cover for Reverend Victoria. I'm so happy that I get to be a support for you so that you can just enjoy a nice vacation. So thank you very much.
So you're in good hands, I'm telling you.
I hope so.
You're You're in good hands.
So as I was preparing to come over here, I was wondering, what am I guided to do through this month? And after speaking with Victoria and everything, what came to me was really to visualize that during my time here, we will be in a capsule. And we have called that the expansion capsule. And essentially, I'm going to, through the Sunday services, weekly meditations, and my last Sunday here, we'll have an afternoon together, guide you through four initiatives or attitudes, perspective that can truly expand your consciousness level. So it's almost like one will build on the other, and then the last one, like I said, we'll have a workshop. And in gratitude for my time here, I decided I'm going to cook for you a Puerto Rican meal. So I'm going to come here the day before. I already know what I'm making. And we'll have some salsa music. You have to understand, it. Back in Triangle, they call me the party minister. So I have to So anyways, come to me. I made a brochure that it really tells you more details what I'll be doing. And then I'll send some more. So during the upcoming weeks, you can not only mark your calendars, but you might want to bring a friend and have that friend be part of the expansion capsule. Mm-hmm. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Ravana. Sure. We also have a photographer. I mean, it's nice with that. I'm telling you. All right. Thanks. All right. So we're ready to welcome in the children.
And the angel's going to wear my red shoes. Yes. And today's deeper dive discussion is led by Dolores Branch in room 103. This is an opportunity to gather, discuss takeaways from today's talk. Bring your coffee and snacks and join us for a deeper dive into today's Sunday message starting at 12:30. Usually there's a line of children out there.
Yeah. Okay. Knee deep in craft.
Okay.
Well, it is a little early. Well, we can sing and maybe they'll get the idea that we want them down here.
I'm Shannon Prieto, the director. Come on up, Eden. We were ensconced, we were focused on making our petals and our flowers, and it took a good chunk of time. And then you all finished early. Come on now. and then on the petals, hopefully today, which was going to be the next step, is to write down the things that we love about ourselves. Kindness, curiosity, thoughtfulness, compassion, things of that nature. We'll do that when we get to that. Big thanks to Kate and Marnie for their help. What else? Yeah, we're talking about the power of love and how it can bloom and send forth that love to others. And, you know, it's a lifelong practice that we're starting from the very young. looking for volunteers for May. I'll be emailing you all, but you know what? Don't make me work. Come to me. What else? Oh, sure.
Can you open this for Shane?
This is what it feels like to volunteer with Shannon.
Yeah.
Just tear it open. Something for the Wi-Fi program.
Thank you, Mary Angela.
Suggestions for a name for me? I don't have a name.
Yeah. Anybody come up with a name? Six different names for them to choose from.
Ten.
Ted. Ted is a name for the rooster.
No. Okay, what's another one?
Mom.
Lucy? A rooster named Lucy. I like that.
Lucy. Evan, what'd you say?
Egbert.
Like Ross.
I was thinking Roosie.
Edward.
Ross and Roosie.
Ross.
Roose for rooster.
Okay. All right. Sheldon.
Sheldon.
Good name. Did you have a name?
One more.
Allie. Do you want to? What name should we give the rooster? Mick. Mickey.
Mick. Okay.
Mick. Avison, do you have a name for our rooster? Oh, cool.
Okay.
All right. We appreciate you.
Stay tuned. You'll find out what the name turns out to be next time.
It's a cliffhanger. So I guess you all have to come back next week. All right, let's bless the children.
Bless the children. Blessing our children. We love you. We bless you. We appreciate you just the way you are. And we behold the Christ in you. Mwah! Please, if we can, we stand up to our prayer of protection, holding hands, singing the song, saying goodbye, see you next week. Take a deep breath, feeling your presence. The light of God surrounds us. I am the light of God. The love of God enfolds us. I am the love of God. The power of God protects us. I am the power of God. The presence of God watches over us. I am the presence of God. Wherever we are, God is and all is well. Woo!
Let me
video has inspired you, opened your heart, expanded your consciousness, filled you with hope, empowered you in some way, we encourage you to support what we offer here at Unity Center of Peace. Hi. If this video has inspired you, opened your heart, expanded your consciousness, filled you with hope, empowered you in some way, we encourage you to support what we offer here at Unity Center of Peace by making your donation now. And thank you. Hi. If this video has inspired you, opened your heart, expanded your consciousness, filled you with hope, empowered you in some way, we encourage you to support what we offer here at Unity Center of Peace by making your donation now. And thank you. Hi. If this video has inspired you, opened your heart, expanded your consciousness, filled you with hope, empowered you in some way, we encourage you to support what we offer here at Unity Center of Peace by making your donation now. And thank you. Hi. If this video has inspired you, opened your heart, expanded your consciousness, filled you with hope, empowered you in some way, we encourage you to support what we offer here at Unity Center of Peace by making your donation now. And thank you. Hi. If this video has inspired you, opened your heart, expanded your consciousness, filled you with hope, empowered you in some way, we encourage you to support what we offer here at Unity Center of Peace by making your donation now. And thank you. Hi. If this video has inspired you, opened your heart, expanded your consciousness, filled you with hope, empowered you in some way, we encourage you to support what we offer here at Unity Center of Peace by making your donation now. And thank you. Hi. If this video has inspired you, opened your heart, expanded your consciousness, filled you with hope, empowered you in some way, we encourage you to support what we offer here at Unity Center of Peace by making your donation now. And thank you. Hi. If this video has inspired you, opened your heart, expanded your consciousness, filled you with hope, empowered you in some way, we encourage you to support what we offer here at Unity Center of Peace by making your donation now. And thank you. Hi. If this video has inspired you, opened your heart, expanded your consciousness, filled you with hope, empowered you in some way, we encourage you to support what we offer here at Unity Center of Peace by making your donation now. And thank you. Hi. If this video has inspired you, opened your heart, expanded your consciousness, filled you with hope, empowered you in some way, we encourage you to support what we offer here at Unity Center of Peace by making your donation now. And thank you. Hi. If this video has inspired you, opened your heart, expanded your consciousness, filled you with hope, empowered you in some way, we encourage you to support what we offer here at Unity Center of Peace by making your donation now. And thank you. Hi. If this video has inspired you, opened your heart, expanded your consciousness, filled you with hope, empowered you in some way, we encourage you to support what we offer here at Unity Center of Peace by making your donation now. And thank you. Hi. If this video has inspired you, opened your heart, expanded your consciousness, filled you with hope, empowered you in some way, we encourage you to support what we offer here at Unity Center of Peace by making your donation now. And thank you. Hi. If this video